Meet Ali Abuelouafa, the first Moroccan to take part in the World University Rowing Championships. As usual, I come alone to these championships because, in fact, there are just a very few of us who do rowing in Morocco. But I have the opportunity of training here in France, and that is why I've come to these World Championships at Gravelines. I graduated last year in Morocco, and I had a choice of staying in my country and continuing my studies, but stopping rowing, or living this adventure, both sporting and human, by continuing to practice rowing and getting a good academic degree. My day begins at 5:30 a.m. Wake up, 6:30 at the club, we train, 8 o'clock to the university until 6, and me, unluckily, I have to work after that to pay my way in life. I go to work, I get back home at 11, I revise my lessons quickly, go to bed, and go again. South Africa notwithstanding, Ali says he's the only rower to represent the African continent. South Africa is not Africa because they have a sports program like European countries. First of all, they don't take part in the African Championships. They make the World Championships directly because they have a very high standard. I would say Morocco is the representative of the whole of Africa, so I've got a lot of pressure on me here. A student in physical education at the University of Nantes, Ali's taking part in the single sculls with a boat he got here because he doesn't have the means to bring his own. It's a boat that was lent to me by the International Rowing Federation. Thanks to them, otherwise I couldn't participate in these championships. Those accustomed to their own boat are more likely to be a medalist or a world champion, of course, while we, who come from developing countries in rowing, always have to cope with boats that aren't ours. Fortunately, there are volunteers here to help us. For 3 days, I've been joined by a volunteer who's been doing her best to be there just when I need it. I'm a volunteer at the World Rowing Championships, and I've been given the mission of being an angel. An angel is somebody who provides information to some of the nations. Ali, well, when I saw that he was alone, not even with a coach or a representative, because I know rowing, and I said to myself, I've got to give him the maximum possible assistance. For example, for the adjustment of his boat, I've tried to find people, because there must be at least two or three people to adjust the boats, and after that, to encourage him in his race. Well, he's all alone, and sometimes that's difficult. So here's Ali in the C final of the University World Championships. Against him, an Austrian, a Norwegian, an Australian, an Italian, and a Malaysian. A difficult race for the Moroccan, and the conditions haven't really helped him. Yeah, the conditions are very difficult. There's a lot of crosswind, so it was hard for me to paddle in those conditions. Finally, I tried to hook up with the others, but I failed, really. And in the last 500 meters, I also had the jury boat waves against me. So it was difficult, and that's it. Nevertheless, the essentials remain. I'm really proud to be the representative of Morocco. I would have preferred it if there'd been more of us at these championships, but I'm the first, the pioneer, if you like, and I hope there'll be other Moroccan rowers to come. It's over. And I pay for one night more.
Today's stars, tomorrow's leaders. When education meets sport and culture, what best promotes excellence in mind and body? Where do friendship, integrity, and achievement meet? Which event gathers the best student-athletes from around the world? The Universiade, the home of international university sports. Today's stars, tomorrow's leaders.